regarding a book that came out, was not published by me, but it's a brilliant text to study the surahs of Mecca. It's not a Quran. It's not a Mus'haf. I have a very high isnad, probably higher than a lot of the guys out there when it comes to Quran. So I've memorized it since I was a child. I read it and complete it very often. I know its order as is. Starting from Surah Al-Fatiha to Surah Al-Nas, I've been the Imam of Taraweeh. There are full Quran recitals in my voice online that are available and so on. So to think and to imagine, to even think for a moment, I came up with a new Quran is devilish. It shows stupidity and ignorance. That's what it shows. So it's not a Quran. It's not a Mus'haf. Mus'haf meaning it doesn't even have the Arabic in it. It's not even part of what we would like you to recite for ibadah or for salah or for anything of that. It's only a study of how the Quran was revealed. Nothing more than that and nothing less than that. So basically, for those who've been making a big noise, you know what happens? When there is a popular person, and we have to say this, it would be in the best interests of little guys to actually come out and make a big noise about it, and they haven't even spoken to the person. It goes to show they'll raise things that happened 20 years ago that were clarified, 10 years ago that were clarified, things that didn't happen that were a confusion. They want to raise it again and again. It goes to show it's not about the app. It's not about the book. It's about you gaining likes and perhaps beyond that, earning money through those views. It happens. So therefore, when you see these controversies, take it in your stride. A lot of people will still make a video about this one here. I don't care. It's fine. We are serving the ummah in the best possible way, fi sabilillah. If anything, we have higher qualifications than they do, by far. We've been serving the ummah for longer than they have. We have scholars we are connected to that they wouldn't even imagine because they don't know. We don't have to make it public and make a big noise and a big thing about it. So, wallahi, it's a shame. It's a shame for people to make a noise. It's a shame for people to make a noise. And then they say, oh, this guy's not a Muslim. This guy is now this. It's about time we called him a kafir and whatever. What on earth are you talking about? My brother, we've converted more than 10,000 people and we're not even counting. Subhanallah, every day and every moment and every other day, there's people converting, reverting to Islam. Walillahi alhamdu wal minna. It's okay, it's fine. The thing is, what on earth are you on about? You don't even know me, my brother. You don't even have a clue who we are. You haven't even bothered to ask firsthand. You don't even know. You want to jump straight into the bandwagon and make your big statements. I suggested to the publishers of that study book to say, if perhaps you might choose a better title, it may and disallow these noisemakers and these people who forcefully want to find fault to actually find fault in the name. So they have considered it, they've taken it on board, and inshallah they will make their announcements. If you want to know more about that Quran translation or what they call the Quran, which is actually a study of the surahs of Mecca, and then another volume that studies Surah Baqarah, another one that studies other surahs of Medina Munawwara. Yeah, like I said, it's an amazing piece of work. But if you want to know more about it, go to the website, go to the FAQs and go and check what it's all about. Go and see firsthand. Don't just listen to things online and get excited because there's one guy who nobody knows. One guy who's really a hater, a grave worshipper sometimes, proper. And they'll come and say, this guy is like this. And do you know who's talking? Do you know who is talking and who they are? I know a brother who was so frightened to be circumcised after he reverted to Islam that he has not yet circumcised. And I, you know, subhanAllah, I'm no one to judge him, but it's a fact. And he's the guy who makes the most noise online. Wow. And I'm thinking, if people knew what happened to you, my brother, I promise you, you would be so ashamed of even opening your mouth. So may Allah forgive those guys. I promise you, they have no power and strength to do something that's fitrah, that they're supposed to have gotten done. And they want to make a noise and do takfir of the rest of the ummah who's working hard day and night. I'm not even supposed to maybe making this video, but subhanAllah, if you see me, it doesn't bother me. We work for Allah. The only sad part is they're inciting violence. They're inciting hurt and hate, and people have already threatened us. And subhanAllah, people have tried to hurt us. So that is probably a thing. We're gathering the info. One day when we need to use it against you, wallahi, we will. And we will in a big way. Not to say that I don't forgive you. Forgiveness is something I don't hold against people. Wallahi, you know what? Where Allah, what Allah has given us, He hasn't given them at all, at all. So we thank Allah. And you know what? If this is the case, it was people like this who are in our equation that Allah has blessed us as a result of. So it's fine. Alhamdulillahi ala dhalik. But We need to stop it, because if we don't, they will attack others who are not as strong as I am in terms of thick-skinned. They will probably attack others in a bigger way. I really believe some of them are mentally deranged. That's what I do believe. When you watch them, it's clear. I mean, people want to argue about things that they don't even know. And they think they know. They haven't even been in the field of da'wah. They don't have a strategy in da'wah. They don't think. They don't serve a specific category. They just swipe everywhere. They want everyone to do exactly what they do and how they understand it. Or maybe a sheikh or two they follow understood it.